Good afternoon, children. Hope you all are doing well. You all look good and healthy. Nice. This is Betty Kurula, and I welcome you all for your chemistry class. And this class is for class 6. Today, we will be discussing chapter 3, which you have already learned once before. So today we will be revising the chapter while focusing on some important points. Since this is a revision class, I expect this class to be an interactive session. So let's start the chapter. First of all, what is a pure substance? See, what is a pure substance? A pure substance is made of only one kind of material. A pure substance is made of only one kind of material. Examples: gold, diamond, oxygen, glucose, etc. See, in a pure substance we can see only one kind of material. Now, what is a material? The matter of which an object is made is called a material. The matter of which an object is made is called a material. Now, matter exists in three different states that you know: solid, liquid and gas. Now, next we will study about mixtures. What are mixtures? Mixtures are formed when two or more substances are mixed in any ratio. Here you can see, when two or more substances are mixed in any ratio, we can call it as a mixture. Now, the different substances that make up the mixture are called components or constituents. The substances with which the mixture is made are called the components or the constituents. Now, next you can see, mixtures are of two types. You can see here, mixtures are of two types. One is homogeneous mixture and the other is heterogeneous mixture. Now, what is the difference between these two? See, homogeneous mixtures, the constituents are evenly spread and each part has the same property. See, in a homogeneous mixture, if you take any part of the mixture, you can see the components are evenly spread and therefore they have the same property. But in heterogeneous mixtures, see, the constituents are not evenly spread and each part does not have the same property. It is not evenly spread and therefore different parts have different property also. Now next, we will see the properties of mixtures. We have already discussed all these things. I am repeating these properties of mixtures. The first property of mixture is the constituents can be in any ratio. The constituents can be in any ratio, it can be mixed in any ratio. That means the percentage of the constituents can be in any ratio. Second, they can be separated from the mixture by different methods. These constituents can be separated by different methods. And the third is, the mixtures do not have fixed melting point and boiling point. Now, what do you mean by this boiling point? See, that is the temperature at which the liquid boils. We know that the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So, these are the properties of mixtures. Once again, I am repeating this. The constituents can be in any ratio. This can be separated from the mixture by different methods. Mixtures do not have fixed melting point and boiling point. Now next we will see. Now some examples of mixtures. Can see, air is a mixture. It is a mixture of different gases. Then tap water, it is also a mixture. It is a mixture of water, salt and minerals. Now, milk is a mixture of water, fat, protein, sugar and some other substances. There are many examples of mixtures, ice cream, mango shake, etc. All these are different types of mixtures. Now, concrete mixture, that is also a mixture. It is made by mixing water, cement, sand, etc. So all these are different types of mixtures. Now the next we will study, why do we need to separate the components of a mixture? Why do we need to separate the components of a mixture? See, there are different reasons. See, the first one is to remove undesirable or harmful substances. Suppose there is a mixture of rice and pebbles or sand. So we used to separate the sand or the pebbles from the rice. There are different methods of separating the undesirable things from the mixture. Now second is to obtain useful constituents. To obtain useful substances from the mixture, you can separate the useful substances. One example is, you can separate butter from milk, like ghee, cream, etc. Similarly, petrol, diesel, kerosene from crude oil. So this is to obtain useful constituents from the mixture. And the third one is to obtain pure substance. See, these pure substances are needed for making medicines, and also it is used in laboratories. So these are the reasons of separating the constituents. First one is to remove undesirable substances or harmful substances. Second is to obtain useful substances. And third is to obtain pure substances. Now next we will study the different methods of separation. What are the different methods of separation? See, these mixtures can be of solid and solid, solid and liquid, like that. So first we will discuss the methods of separating solids from solids. See, the different methods are, number one, it is threshing mixtures. The first method we are going to discuss is threshing. Now what is this threshing? See, threshing is a method of separating grains from the plants or the chaff. This we do after harvesting. See, after harvesting, the plants are tied into bundles. It is then beaten on a hard surface to separate the grains, and this process is called the threshing. See, after threshing, the grains may also contain some dried parts of the leaves, etc. So we have to separate that also. That comes a second method. It is called a winnowing. So winnowing is the second method of separation. This is used to separate light particles from the grains, and this is done with the help of wind. Now the third method is hand picking. See, hand picking method is used when the one of the constituent is lesser in quantity. Then only you can do this, use this method, hand picking method, when the quantity of the impurity is small. One example is to remove stones from rice. We use this hand picking method. This is done only when the impurities are less in quantity. Now the fourth method is sieving. Number four, sieving. See, there are different types of sievers. We know that, see, we use a strainer to separate tea leaves from tea. Okay, that is called a tea strainer. We also use a sieve to separate the grains or the mustard seeds, whatever undesirable things which are present in the wheat flour or rye flour, etc. So for that also we use another type of sieve. you must have seen where the concrete work is going on. There they use a wire mesh to separate sand or the gravel from the sand by using another sieve. So sieves are used when the constructions they have different sizes. This is used when the constructions are different sizes. So the fifth one is magnetic separation. The next is magnetic separation. Magnetic separation. See, this method is used. See, suppose in the mixture iron fillings are there, you can separate the iron fillings by using a magnet. We know the property of the magnet; it will attract the iron metals, iron fillings, etc. So these are the different methods of separating solids from solids. So once again, we will revise the topics which we have learned now. First of all, it was pure substance. Pure substance, the substances which is made of only one kind of material is called a pure substance. Now mixtures are formed when two or more substances are mixed in any ratio. The different substances which are mixed or which make up the mixture are called the constituents or the components. Now third, after that we have seen there are two types of mixtures: homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures, the constituents are evenly spread, but in heterogeneous mixtures, the different part have the different ratio. So that means the components are not evenly spread. Now we have seen many examples of mixtures like air, tap water, milk, ice cream, mango shake, etc. After that we have seen the properties of mixtures. See the properties. The first property of mixture is this can be in any ratio, that it differs from part to part, and constituents can be separated from a mixture by different methods. And the third, mixtures do not have fixed melting point and boiling point. Now after that we have seen what is the necessity of separating the substances from a mixture, or why do we need to separate the components of a mixture. The first reason is to remove undesirable or harmful substances. There we have seen the example of separating sand from rice. Now second is to obtain useful constituents, that is the separation of butter, ghee, cream, etc. from milk. That is the example of it, useful constituents. Third is to obtain pure substances. See, pure substances are needed for making medicines and they are also used in laboratories. After that we have seen the methods of separation. There are different types of mixtures. The mixture can be solid and solid, solid and liquid, etc. So first we have seen the separation of solids from solids. The first method is threshing. That is the first method of separating the solid from solid. This method is used to separate the grains from the chaff of the plants. For this, after harvesting, the plants are tied into bundles. It is then beaten on a hard surface to separate the grains, and that method is called a threshing. Now after threshing, see, the grains may also contains dry leaves and some other light particles. This can be separated by the method of winnowing. This winnowing is done with the help of wind. Now after that, see, here the property which is used here is winnowing. The lighter particles can be blown away with the help of wind. The lighter particles can be blown away with the help of wind. Now when we fold the grains which is containing the dry leaves, if you fall against the wind or the fan, you can see that the lighter leaf particles can be blown away and leaving behind the grains just directly down that. Now the third one is hand picking method. This method is used when the quantity of impurities is small. When the impurities are in small quantity, then only this method is used, hand picking. One example is to remove stones from rice. After that, we have seen sieving. Sieving is the different method in which different types of sieves are used. One example is to remove grains from the floor. Then another example is to remove gravel and the other bigger particles from the sand. Then we have also seen the example of separating tea leaves from tea by using tea strainer. So these are the examples of sieving method. Now the fifth one is magnetic separation. In this we know that iron is magnetic, that means magnet will attract these iron particles. So if in a mixture the iron fillings are there, we can separate this by using a magnet. So this is the last property method, that is magnetic separation. So all these are about the separation of solids from solids. Now next we can study the separation of solids from liquids. How can we separate solids from liquids? See, there are different methods. The first method is sedimentation. See, in this sedimentation method, the solid particles are allowed to settle down. For that, you have to keep the mixture undisturbed for some time. Then the solid particles will settle down. And this way can separate the solids from the liquid. Then after that, you can pour out the top clear water into another container. So the first process is sedimentation. In this method, the heavier insoluble substances are allowed to settle down at the bottom of the container. Then the water containing the impurities can be separated by pouring out the water into another container. Now second method is decantation method. This decantation method is followed after sedimentation method. First you have to settle down the heavier impurities. After that you can pour out the top layer water into another container. So this method is called the decantation method. See, in the previous examples of this hand picking, there we have seen that the rice from the stones from the rice can be separated by hand picking method. If the amount is larger in quantity, then we can use this decantation method. So for that, first you have to mix the rice which is containing the insoluble impurities like the stones, mix with water. Then it is taken in a container and another container is kept below that, and you have to fold or shake the container in which the mixture is taken. It is slowly, then you can see that the rice particles will be transferred to the other container. So this is an example of decantation method. And the third method is filtration. It is another method of separating insoluble impurities. See, all of you know what is filtration method. See, what all things are required for filtration. Filtration, you need filter paper, you need filtering device, that can be filter paper, a funnel, stand, a rod, etc. So what you have to do, first you have to fix the funnel on a stand. Then you take the filter paper, it is fold into two halves. Again you have to fold it, then it will be divided into four equal parts. Now from these four equal parts, you take three parts in one side and one part on the other side. You can fix it inside the funnel. Now the mixture which is to be purified is poured into this funnel slowly. Then you can see that the water will trickle down to the funnel, and this we can collect in another container. So this is filtration method. See, this is the third method of separating solid from a mixture, from mixture of solid and a liquid. So these are the three different methods. Now we know that suppose you have given a mixture of muddy water, from this how can you separate the pure water from that? See, for that you have to keep this muddy water undisturbed for some time. Now see, the mud particles are very light, so it will take a lots of time to settle down. So in that case you can add or put one alum, a piece of alum in that water. Then what will happen, the alum dissolves fast and that will settle down or deposit on the mud particles, makes it heavy and settle down faster, and that process is called a bloating. So these are the different methods of separating solids from liquids. The first method is sedimentation, second method is decantation, third method is filtration, and the fourth method is bloating. So remember, in bloating we put a piece of alum that will dissolve in the water, which will deposit on the suspended light particles of mud, makes it heavy and that will settle down fast. So these are the different methods of separating solids from a liquid. Now we have seen different methods of separation. Next we will study, see, different types of separation are there, so you have to identify the methods also. Suppose you can separate butter from milk, then another separation is separation of leaves from any pulses or any other things, rice etc., separation of stones from rice, then purification of water. So different methods are used in these methods. In these mixtures, the constituents are separated by different methods. Now, which property of substance is used in the separation of sieving? Do you know which property is used in the process of sieving? In sieving, we use a property that the constituents are, that is the difference in the size. When the particles are differ in their size, this method is used. Now, the sedimentation of mud mixed with water can be separated by adding dash. Do you know what is that? It is called an alum. So, third question, while making sweet lemonade, why do we stir it with a spoon? Why do we stir it with a spoon while making lemonade? We know that while stirring, the sugar will dissolve fast. And therefore, while making the lemonade, we stir the mixture with the help of a spoon. Now, you have to, in the next class, we will study the different methods of separating two miscible liquids and two immiscible liquids. See, two miscible liquids can be separated by the process of distillation. We also use evaporation and the condensation method. Different methods are there. When a solid dissolves in the water, we can use the evaporation method and condensation method. See, what is this evaporation method? We know that common salt is obtained from sea water by the process of evaporation. Sea water contains common salt. So evaporation method is used here. First, the water is taken in big tanks. It is then kept in the sun for some days. Then the water in that tank will evaporate slowly because of the sun heat and leaving behind the salt. So this method is used. That method is called evaporation. So evaporation method is used to separate common salt from sea water. Now the next is condensation. This condensation method is used when you have to collect the water also. See, do you know what is evaporation? Evaporation is the process of changing a liquid into vapor, and condensation is the process of changing water vapor into or vapor into liquid. So this condensation process method is used to separate water from the mixture of sea water which contains common salt. So what will happen there? We have to boil the water or heat the water. The water changes into water vapor. Now you have to condense it, cool it. Then while cooling, the water vapor changes into water again. So this is the method called the condensation. So these two methods are used for separating soluble liquids from liquids. Soluble solids from liquids. That is evaporation and the condensation. So children, many methods of separation we have seen here. That is, first we have seen the separation of solids from solids. After that we have seen the separation of solids from the liquids, and now we have seen how soluble liquids can be separated from the mixture. That is by the process of evaporation and condensation. So in the next class we will study the separation of miscible liquids and immiscible liquids. Miscible liquids means when two liquids mix with each other, they are called as miscible liquids. The examples are water and milk. It is a miscible liquid in which the both of this liquid mix well with each other. And suppose you are mixing water and oil, they do not mix with each other and thereby it forms different layers. So they are called as immiscible liquids. Now the method of separation of this miscible liquids and immiscible liquids we will study in the next class. And I hope all these concepts are clear to you, and I think you can do the questions which is given at the end of the chapter. So the next class we will study the next methods. Till then, thank you so much.